fuck me, it's just this place. Oh, well. Okay, never mind. Oh my god, that's an old reference. Hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Metroid 1! Hoo-ah! Like how I said one in that mighty voice, right, as Samus mightily puts her hands on her hips as she rides the elevator up back to Brinstar, where we're going to explore Brinstar and clear it of its valuables! Hoo-ah! Alright, let's go. Back in the happy music zone, there's a couple things we can pick up left in Brinstar. I think there's literally three things we can pick up here. Before going down to Kraid's hideout, and then once we're done with Kraid's hideout, then it's time to go finish the game! Bobble, bobble! I don't know why I said bobble there, but, you know. If this goes actually, if this goes fast enough, we might have the finale on our hands here. I didn't really think about that, because it's not going to take that long to do the end game. The end game to this game probably won't take longer than 10 minutes. And then I don't know how much longer I could possibly, you know, faff about on the end screen, not doing anything before it's like, okay, I get it. So if we end up getting down, like, completing everything and beating Kraid in, like, 20 minutes, I might just go ahead and beat the game in this video. Because, you know, hey, I'm gonna be out saving the world anyway. Okay, so this room right here, you can, holy crap, what the hell was that? One of these, wait, this isn't right. Oops, I didn't go far up enough. Dang it. Okay, I thought that room didn't look quite right. I thought the room we're looking for has, like, it's not bubbles, it's made of, like, tile. It's all the way at the top of that golden shaft that we were just, that we just exited shortly, a few minutes, yeah, this one. At the very, very tippy top of this shaft is a path to the right, which leads to the various suit, missile tank, and an energy tank. So let's go get them. And it's quite an interesting little area. It's an area that I always think about when I play this game. All right, here we are with these weird, like, tubes. Just like an unforgettable bit of decor there. I don't know why it keeps registering two inputs when I push X. Like it'll drop two bombs, even though I only pushed the button one time. Like right there, it just dropped two bombs. So weird, dude. Like there, I just dropped like four bombs there. Holy crap. Holy carp. Holy shark. Dude, let me out of here. There we go. Haha. I avoided falling on you by opening up in midair to slow my descent. I bet you weren't expecting that, were you, you little zoomer? Okay, this room. Right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and there you go. Just wait a couple seconds, and then jump. And then, with the high jump, you can get up, okay, excuse me, with the high jump, excuse me, I'd say, with the high jump, you can get up here and open this door. Because my hair has security clearance to get through this door. This is just the episode of The Mighty Voice, isn't it? Da, ba, ba, ba. Oh, so much energy. Oh my god, it's delicious. Oh, go, 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 go. Ooh, that was close. And there we go. Finally. About time we picked this up. This various suit will cut all damage we receive in half. Which would have been really helpful in Ridley's hideout, but we didn't actually really need it. I mean, we've made out for ourselves pretty well so far in this LP. I'm pretty impressed, actually. This has been one of my smoother playthroughs so far, at least. Who knows how bad? I don't know though. The fight with Mother Brain is a real pain in the ass. Like, it's one of my least favorite final bosses in, like, video game history. Maybe. I really hate the fight with Mother Brain in this game because it's barely even a fight. It's just like, I don't know. It's just stage hazards, but they're just everywhere, and they never fucking leave you alone. And there's SpaghettiOs. It's like, god. It's like they made the Powerpuff Girls, but out of annoying shit, you know. Alright. Now if you go up here, you can come through Shmia, freeze that guy so he doesn't get in your way, and then screw attack him, as it were. I think you want to get through... Where do you want to go here? Oh, you know what? I think that's just a... Yeah, this is just a hole. You don't have to break that open. It's just a hole. And there's an energy tank. Huzzah! Now, we could backtrack out of this place, but I think I'm just going to keep going right here, because we're like a hop, skip, and a jump away from that, from the same shaft we first explored to get to where the bombs were. So, might as well just keep going. Yeah, so that up there, if you had the ice beam and the high jump boots, you could, what you could do there is use those, like, back and forth guys, freeze them as platforms, just like in Super Metroid, to get back up into, oh man, nice shot, to get up to that energy tank. But you could just go up around on the left, and then you'd get the Varia suit too, so I don't know why they even bother, really. Alright. So now that we've gotten those, it's time to make our way back down to where we... Just about to where we started the game, actually. If you remember on our first way to the right, there was that room where there were bombable blocks forming a bridge over a pit. Like, right at the beginning of the game, we're going there. Because if you break through those blocks, that goes down to Kraid's hideout. Which, while not quite as dangerous as Ridley's hideout, Kraid is a significantly greater threat than Ridley, because you have to get in there and fight him. You can't fight... There are no safe places to stand. I mentioned that in the last episode. I'm just reiterating here, I guess. Ow. Oh, I got acid reflux.
If you got heartburn, I tell you what, you need to get Prilosec. Get her done.
Ow. Alright. Here is also where we can pick up another energy tank if we want. I'm going to wait on it, though. The energy tank is right there? Yep, right there. It's tricky to get to say the least. The easiest way I found to do it is wait for one of these zoomers to climb across the ceiling and then freeze it when it's on its way down the wall. But, anyway. Yeah, come down here. And this leads down to Kraid's hideout. And there's not much of a walk, either. Like, just through this door and boom, you're here. I'm gonna pick up that energy tank on the way up to, Turian. Because Turian is actually up through Brinstar, in the upper left corner of Brinstar. So that's the best way to do that. So, Kraid's hideout. Not a lot of stuff in here. There's a missile through this door. And if you keep going past the missile, you'll get to this area, kind of like that area in Norfair where we got all those extra missiles, except there's nothing up there. It's just like this little maze of rooms with nothing in it, so just don't even bother. Just turn around as soon as you get that missile. I know it's not really in the spirit of the game to, you know, already know exactly where everything is and not explore anything, but frankly, it's just a pain in the ass. And I don't feel like dealing with it. So I'm not going to. And if that's a crime, then I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Okay. And here's another missile. And yet again, not really much past this point, I don't think. No, not really. You may as well turn back after that one, too. Thankfully, with the Varia suit, the lava hurts you much more slowly, so it's a lot easier to save yourself if you get knocked down off the platforms. That's a big part of why I prefer to get the Varia suit before going to Ridley's hideout, is just because of how much it protects you from the lava. Oh, Northern Lion just went live. Cool. Thanks for muscling into my fucking video. Through here, we have an energy tank, which I'm going to go pick up right now, because why the hell not? I want to have 6 energy tanks for Kraid. I don't think I'm really going to need them, but it'll be nice to have. Besides, there's an energy tank right behind Kraid, so... Okay. I think what I'm going to do... I don't know. I don't really know the best way to do this. Oh, man, we got it! Awesome! That was smooth as ice. Smooth as butter. Smooth as a tub full of margarine. I don't know why I'm suddenly talking like some kind of... What? Never mind. That's all that's over here, so you can safely turn back now. I wish you'd stop knocking me further out of those bombs. I wish you'd stop knocking me out of those tunnels further than I want to move. It's really getting my gander. Okay, so a little ways further down here, there's a door over there. That's kind of a pain to get to, but it's not really that difficult. There's actually a ledge beneath it on the right that you can stand on and then high jump to it, or you could always do this. I think actually even just unmorphing in midair is enough to slow your descent to the point where you can get into this door, get onto that ledge, but whatever. These things on the ground always looked hilarious to me. They look like I got big, giant, googly eyes. They're like... It just looks so goofy. Unfortunately, I can't say the same about these skeeters coming out of the freaking acid. These guys are quite annoying. And I'm gonna... Yeah, there you go. Those guys are really bad about hitting you while you're going through a door. Because, don't forget to get this missile. I almost missed that. This missile is really annoying to get to because it's in a really bad spot. Just make sure you get it on the way down so that you don't have to stop by on the way up, where the stakes are much higher. Man, I shot those two enemies with the ice beam and the ice beam shots hit at like the exact same time as I took damage from that other guy. Okay. I'm not really doing a very good job of showing off this area. There's actually... Oh, man, actually, you know, now that I think about it, there's a missile pack down there that's going to be a real pain for me to get to. Unless I take a huge detour. I didn't realize there was a missile pack down there. Right now, we are on the way to real Kraid. There are 2 Kraids, and one of them is a fake. So obviously, you don't want to be fooled by a fake Kraid. The real Kraid is right in here. And he's kind of a piece of work. He looks like some weird looking... I didn't want to go back through the door, you buffoon. Jeez. Okay, let's try that again. If I can get up to him. The best way to deal with this guy is to just get in his face and pound away on him. Just total disregard for your own safety. Just go fucking hog wild. Go to Zulma's Lasagna and get deep in the paint. That wasn't so bad. Man, I kicked his ass fast. He didn't even get off 2 energy tanks. There's also an energy tank right there, which, if you want to pick that up, go into a morph ball here and slot in like that. If you try to go into a morph ball from this platform and slide into that, you'll fall past it. Don't ask me why, that's just how it is. Alright, there you go. Now we've beaten both of Mother Brain's lieutenants, both of Mother Brain's space pirate captains. We could go right up to Turian and take on the bitch herself now if we wanted to. But first we have to get out of Kraid's hideout, and there's also one missile pack left to collect in here, which I want to get, of course. And getting out of here is a real... ish. Because of this climb. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the famous climb. Basically, the best way I can figure to do this is do something like that, and then free up enough space for you to jump to the next safe platform. I wouldn't advise. You could, if you wanted to, you could just try to stay inside the tower, shoot the blocks above you, and then jump as they reform, but I wouldn't recommend it, because if a block perchance should regenerate on top of you, it'll knock you, it'll hit you, and it'll knock you out of the stack, and if it knocks you to the right, there's no recovering from it, you'll fall all the way back down. Oh, thank God, that was awesome. Okay. Gonna wait for those to replenish themselves. We're almost done. We're almost out. There we go. Whew, thank God, that went very smoothly. Don't fall down now. Okay, good. Excellent, excellent. Keep it doing, keep it doing. Ow. And you don't really need to worry too much about your missiles going into Turian either, because, like I mentioned in the last episode, the Metroids in Turian will drop, like, 30 missiles sometimes when you kill them. It might be 10, but I want to say 30. So restocking your missiles keeping a high stock of missiles for Mother Brain is not really an issue. Okay, so now what do we do? Now what do we do? The last missile pack... If we want to get the last missile pack, we have to go all the way to the left and go down. I think that's the only way to do it. Which means we have to fall down here. Actually, we could probably ride these things up here since we have the ice beam. Yes, indeedy-do. Hey-o! Thank God for the ice beam. This door goes to, like, basically just a C-shaped series of rooms that connects with a door, like, a little bit down, so that's all that's there. It's just, like, some enemies and shit. But if you have the ice beam, you don't have to worry about that. You can just go straight up. Just take the, I wish I could remember what those things were called. Are those? Those aren't zoomers. But they have some name that doesn't sound like the kind of name that an invincible minor minion would have. Like, Boomer or something? I don't know. Oh, here we got more of these weirdly spawning hoppers. You know, the fast racing Neo. Good lord, man. Stop hitting me! Jeez! You're a asshole, you hear me? Yeah, that's right, I said it. I'm not afraid to say it. I'm a brave boy. Alright, so come through here, and... This lava is fake. You fall all the way down. All the way down. Oh my god. All the way down, man. All the way down. And a couple of rooms away from here is... Weird, a missile door? That's a weird place to put a missile door. I think it's in this room. There are missiles. Yep, I can see the structure that holds them coming on screen. There they are. And those are the last missiles to collect in the game. Ladies and gentlemen, we have everything. Except for that last energy tank in Brinstar. But that's it. Now, before we make our way out of Crate's Hideout, I think I will show you where that fake crate is. Because I mentioned that there were two crates and one of them is real. Well, the fake crate is down here. And actually, I don't know how to get to this thing. Can I make it through there? It doesn't look like I can. I'm just now realizing that I legitimately don't know how to get to the fake crate. I know how to get to the real one, but not the fake one. That's weird. Okay, I guess I'm not showing that then, because I legitimately have no idea how to get down to that guy. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how to get down there. Huh. Weird. Wait a second, I think I might know. Ah, but I gotta go. We gotta beat the game in less than 2 hours, man. Sorry, if there are any fake crate enthusiasts. You know, I said, you know, I'm getting, this may be 100% run, but it's not 100% showing everything run, sorry to say. Besides, that would take forever, oh my god, like a full cartographer. Why did the last one not spawn, man? It's How am I supposed to climb this? Dude, how am I supposed to climb this without if the last guy doesn't spawn? Dude, okay, fine. I guess I'll go through this C-shaped series of rooms then. What a wafer. Ow, ow, ow. Now what the hell am I gonna put in the thumbnail if I beat both Crate and Mother Brain in one video? That's gonna be really awkward. Just like that, that's literally the entire, like, just a little bit, just like one last room here, and that's the entire, like, branch that connects those two doors. So it's really simple stuff. And here we are. There's that missile door we had to get to that was a little bit tricky to reach, but, we're done with Crate's hideout, so let's head back up to Brinstar and take the fight to Mother Brain, I guess. Maybe if this goes long enough, I can just split it, but I really don't think we have more than maybe 15 minutes left. Da, da, da. Da, da, da. Da, da. Okay. Jeez. Okay, we'll pick up that energy tank on the way here, on the way up, just to refill our life. Because I'm going to need all the life I can get going into Turian. That place is a pain in the dick. It is not fun. Dude, get out of the way. Okay. Sheesh. Alright. Drink in this excellent music while you still can, because it's about to go away forever. Except for that second playthrough that I was thinking about doing, of course. Alright. If I could get this guy to jump through... Yes! Yes! Beautiful! Oh, you know what? That actually might do it right there. Ha! Oh man, I couldn't have planned better stepping stones if you asked me to. Awesome. I love how we were so close to the ceiling already that when I jumped into the energy tank, Samus didn't even have time to enter her jump pose. She just moved up like 4 pixels while standing perfectly still. That's hilarious. And that's every item in the game, guys. We've got everything. I'm pretty sure I didn't miss anything. I'm sure people will be more than happy to point it out in the comments if I did miss something, but I'm pretty sure that's everything. Other than fake Crate. Sorry, fake Crate. I guess you'll just survive. You know. So past the path to the golden shaft. Past the path to the long beam, all the way up to the tippy-tippy-tippy top of the very first shaft in the game. My god, could the wording of that been any more phallic? To the tippy top of the first shaft? I mean, holy cow. Through this door, we're on our way to the final... I'm trying to think of a word that rhymes with floor, or whatever I said there. I said something that ended in "or," and I was trying to think of a rhyme for it, like the final tour. That doesn't make any sense. The final bore. That's awful rude. Well, whatever. Anyway, here we are, the gate to Turian. And unless you've beaten both Ridley and Crade, you can't shoot their statues here to open the way. Although if you get one of those rippers in here, you can actually freeze it like around here somewheres. And then you can use that to bomb jump into this little nook here and skip straight to Mother Brain. That's what a lot of speedrunners do. Anyway, here we go. You want to be very careful here, because the Metroids in this game are... They don't mess around. They damage you fast, and they hurt like hell. They damage you fast, and they're really hard to get off. Shit. Oh, thank God, that was good. Yeah, those guys do give 30 missiles each. That is ludicrous. Unfortunately, these doors take 10 missiles to open, but when you're getting 30 back from every Metroid you kill, it doesn't even matter. Alright, now do straight jumps here so that you're ready to shoot when one of them appears. There's gonna be one right there. And another one shortly. Yeah, there's one. The orange ones don't move as fast, which is nice. I don't know if they have any, like, if there's anything they do better than the green ones. Like, maybe they do more damage or they're harder to get off of you. That would be my guess. They're harder to get off of you. But obviously I have no proof for that. It's just my guesstimation. That's it for room number two. Now a downward. These downward rooms are the worst. Because you can't shoot down in this game. So, like, you're basically fucked. If they get up too much of a running start and crash into you, there's, like, literally nothing you can do. You just have to let them grab onto you and then shake them off. Thankfully, there aren't too many Metroids in here, apparently. Oh, there's one. Yeah, there's more now that you're here. Oh, God. You get off of me. Whew, that was close. Man, I want more missiles, man. Give me more missiles. Oh, well, I don't think I really need more missiles. I'll kill this guy, see if he drops any. Man! Alright. I think this is the last room that has Metroids in it, but after this, it's Mother Brain. And I am not looking forward to that. Bitch, one bit. Can they take one more shot? Do they all take six missiles? It seems like they take six. Sexy Os 18 sixth. Shit, he got on me. How the hell did that happen? Dude, get off of me! Sheesh. I really need you to drop missiles, man. Those aren't missiles, asshole! Thank you. 190? Okay, I feel pretty good about that going in. Here we go. Here we go! Mother Brain time! Nim, nim, nip, nim, nim! Mother Brain time! Okay, here we go. These Zebatites take a lot of shots, and they're really annoying, and basically they suck, and I hate them, and just shoot them until they're dead. Or try to, at least, because the lag tends to mess with your missile shooting inputs here a lot. And these guys, I swear to God, these Rinkos have more knockback than anything else in the entire game. Like, I swear to Christ, it's like, I can't just be imagining it. It is so bad. Get out of the... Oh my God. Stop! Ugh. And the lag doesn't help either, because this room lags like crazy. Yeah, I didn't... Oh my God, why is it so slippery? Yeah, if you were waiting for salt, well, here's where you're gonna get it. Because this fucking... This final encounter is such a huge pain in my ass. Okay, there we go. We're almost done, actually. There's one more Zebatite, and then it's Mother Brain. But as you can see, I've already taken a bit of a beating. God, you guys! It's because they spawn out of the fucking terrain, so they just appear out of nowhere. Yeah, what you want to do here is try and get her... Oh, God. Dude, get up there! See, the other problem is that if you actually touch Mother Brain, you take damage. But you have to touch her to, like, get in there, you know? Okay, here we go. We can get lots of hits in on her now. Go, 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 come on! There we go, we got her. Ugh. She always takes less missiles than I'm expecting to. Now I gotta get out of here. Oh, go, go, time bomb set, get out fast. Oh, God. 900 seconds, though? How long could this possibly be? Well, the answer is not very long at all. They give you way more time than you need to do this. It's kind of pathetic, honestly. Dude, go, go, go! Jeez. This is so much better in Zero Mission, where, like, not only is the time tighter, but you actually have to go through... Okay, seriously, come on. What the hell are you doing? Do we have to do straight jumps here? Is that what this has come to? We have to do straight jumps to escape at the end of Metroid 1. You've beaten this game in less than an hour before, from scratch, and you can't even do this without fumbling like a fucking chimpanzee. Come on, man. You're like professional. It's like Sam. You're not doing Samus justice here. All right, there we go. We made it. And there you go, and there you have it, guys. That's Metroid 1 for you. Great! You fulfilled your mission. It will arrive peace in space, but it may be invaded by the other Metroid. Pray for a true peace in space. The other Metroid. Zelda M. Zelda Other M. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Looking good, Sammy. Don't you love how that triumphant, happy part of the music comes on right as Samus takes her clothes off? Like, Jesus, man. Just so glad. Well, there you go. I just knocked that out pretty much in an afternoon. I wonder when I actually recorded the first episode, like, what time it was. What time was it when I recorded the first episode of this? It was 1:54. And it is currently 3:57. There were breaks between, but for the most part, this has been one continuous sesh. I'm amazed my throat has held out for this long, although I'm afraid of how bad it's going to be when I stream tonight. I really should be resting my voice, not recording all of Metroid 1. Like, what? For those of you wondering, I'm recording this entire thing on March 19th, which is crazy. That I'm recording this far in advance. Like, Super Mario Land 2 hasn't even started going up yet. I haven't even recorded the last Paper Mario Thousand Year Door bonus video yet. I'm just going crazy. Because I've been wanting to record these short, old games for, like, so long. And I haven't been able to do them because of Hollow Knight and Thousand Year Door taking up so much bandwidth, you know? But now I get to sleep, and tonight will be a breeze. The end. That's quite a fancy little the end screen there. Nice. Now I'm quickly going to make a save state so that I can start from here later. Metroid 1. I didn't make a save state before the finale. Ooh, that could have been bad. Metroid 1, New Game Plus. There you go. I'll just say that. That's good. So now when I want to go back to record the New Game Plus, all I have to do is load that save state and press start, which starts you back at the beginning of the game with all your upgrades as Zero Suit Samus. Wait, what? Okay, it doesn't start you with any of your missiles or energy tank pickups, but you have the screw attack, you have the various suit, you have whatever beam you had equipped, and all that jazz. You have all your upgrades. You don't have any of your pickups. But anyway, we'll worry about that later at a later date. For now, I'm going to say thank you all so much for watching Metroid 1. I hope you enjoyed it because I sure as heck had a blast recording it. This has been really almost relaxing. That was a very smooth playthrough. And stay tuned in the future for a possible New Game Plus run where we will try to beat the game in less than 1 hour to unlock the best ending. As Suitless Samus. I'll see you then. See you whenever. See you in future videos. See you in the future. See you in the future. See you in the fear. Fear!